You've just entered the theater of an alien sky. If the words and images seem strange to you, there's a reason for this. Our world was once a vastly different place. To experience this won't hurt you, and there is nothing to fear. In the celestial formation under discussion here, an unusual arrangement of planets occurred prior to the present organization of the solar system. The events were identified mythically with the lost age of gods and wonders. In a quasi-stable phase of this planetary configuration, the Earth rotated on a single axis with other planets extremely close to our own, such that the axis ran straight through the centers of the gathered bodies as they moved around the sun. The visual result was the appearance in the sky of what we've called the polar configuration. Astronomical traditions recalled this as the great conjunction of primeval times. But the events were recorded under many different names and many different mythic interpretations. It was some 40 years ago that we proposed the concept of planets axially aligned in a polar configuration. In the course of the investigation, the historical evidence itself forced a series of adjustments and extensions of the reconstruction in new directions. As one might imagine, scientifically astute acquaintances immediately declared the arrangement impossible, a glaring contradiction of Kepler's third law. That law would require that the orbital period of the outer body be longer and its orbital velocity slower than that of an inner body. Hence, a close gathering of planets could not stay in line as the bodies moved around the sun. But that was before the structural dynamicist Robert Grubaugh took an interest in the historical evidence and came forward with equations for collinear equilibrium of planet-sized bodies. Collinear equilibrium means equilibrium positions on a straight line running right through the centers of the bodies. Mathematically, at these positions, the bodies will in fact stay in line while moving as a congregation of planets around the sun. Grubaugh's equations were subsequently confirmed by others, including the distinguished mathematician Dr. Robert Bass. Of course, no revelation about mathematical equilibrium could ever settle the complex issues posed by the reconstruction. It's the historical evidence that raises the questions in the first place and provides the acid tests. An acid test means a definitive test, a test the reconstruction must meet if valid, and a test that alternative explanations cannot meet. Consider the example of the Great Conjunction implicit in ancient imagery. When that phrase is used today, it refers to Jupiter overtaking Saturn in its orbit. By calling this close approach a great conjunction, modern-day astrologers and astronomers have effectively trivialized a foundational principle of a much more ancient language and symbolism. The Babylonian astronomer priest Berosus in the 3rd century BC stated the ancient idea unequivocally when he described a planetary arrangement ahead of world-altering catastrophe. Planets centered on a straight line. That's a remarkable statement with no rationale under common assumptions today and no analogy in any planetary observations in our own time. It is, however, a perfect description of the polar configuration as reconstructed from a global accord of ancient witnesses, of which a Babylonian priestly astronomer would have no knowledge. It's also a perfect description of collinear alignment as described mathematically by Robert Grubaugh. In Hindu accounts, we find the popular story of the great citadel of the gods, called Tripura. It was said that the towering citadel was formed by three primeval powers or celestial cities, first moving independently, then coming into perfect alignment. Perfect alignment such that a single arrow of Shiva could pierce the hearts of the gathered powers. But what was the arrow of Shiva? And what was the effect when it was launched against the towering citadel? What happened when the great conjunction dissolved into heaven-shattering catastrophe will be the subject of our next segment.